graphing the trigonometric graphs. So the basic quadratic graphs and the more further more complicated graphs we have seen, okay, like curves, y equal to e to the power of x, exponential and everything. Okay, trigonometric graphs can be, you can more complicated it, okay? So we can transform and we can translate your trigonometric functions, just you like transform and translated other functions in algebra, okay? So here we are going to start with a basic sine function, okay? So this function will be having an amplitude of 1, because your graph is going to be 1 unit up and 1 unit down from your midline of the graph, okay? And the period of the function will be 2 pi, because the sine wave repeats every 2 pi units. That's why. Okay? Fine.
You okay?
So, the graph of a sine function, I'll just show you that. Okay? First thing, just one second, I'll share my screen, George. Yes. No. Just one. See. So, here, the black portion of the graph, okay, represents one period of the function and is one cycle of the sine curve. Okay, see this? This is one period. Okay, the gray portion of the graph indicates that the basic sine curves repeat indefinitely to the left and right. This gray color line is there, right? So that means that it is going to extend indefinitely in both the direction. Okay, so the black portion is saying it is one period. From here to here, it is one period, okay, 0 to 2 pi. Always you know that 0 to 360 degree is one full period, right? So 0 to 2 pi, that is one period, okay? And is one cycle of the sine curve from here to here. Similarly, when you take it to the left hand side, it will have the same time, okay? Fine. So, and when you start curving your, graphing your, that is y equal to sine x, the range will be from negative 1 to 1. That means you are going to some, take some values, 0, pi, pi over 2, 2 pi, like that, okay? For that, the range will be negative 1 to positive 1. You will be getting the values back, okay? So, in the previous section, the domain of sine and cosine functions you would have studied, okay? Set of all real numbers you can take, okay? The range will be negative 1 to 1, fine? And each function will be having a period of 2 pi. Okay, got it, George? Yes?
Yep.
So, how we are graphing it? I can just, you can just do this using the tabular column also. If you are feeling comfortable, just I'll draw for a second and show you for sine graph. Okay, see this. One second. So, I will take a x and y axis. Okay, Josh. Now, the next one, see, first you, normally when you are having a quadratic equation, you will be taking x and y coordinates, right? Same type, we are going to take it here. Okay, Josh? So, first I will take it for x equals to 0, then pi, then 2 pi. Okay? Got it? So, our function is y equal to sine x. So what you will do, sine 0 is 0, okay? Sine pi would be, I hope it is positive 1, right? Pi will be, yes, positive 1. Sine 2 pi would be negative 1. Okay, Josh? Got it? So like that, it keeps on going up and down, okay? So that I'm going to make it on 0, okay? Pi, 2 pi. Okay, this is to the left-hand side, okay? Let's go for the right-hand side also, negative pi, negative 2 pi, okay? So now, we need to calculate it for your, okay, negative side also, I'll calculate it and keep, okay? Negative pi and negative 2 pi. Okay, Josh? So again, the wave will be coming like that only, okay? So your, we need to calculate it for sine 180, I'm correct, I hope so. Yes. So this would be, yeah, 1. Okay. So here it would become negative 1. Okay, Josh? Then this would be positive 1. It will go and touch it here. Okay. So Sorry, touch here means if you come up. I'm sorry. Okay. So now let's start making it out. The graph will be looking like this. Okay. So I need to start giving away. Keep it in mind. Here the amplitude is 1 and the period will be from, each period will be 2 pi. Okay. So if I'm going to have the graph like this, it will start here. Okay, Josh. Mm-hmm. Graph will be coming then. Oops, sorry. It will be coming like this. Okay. Then towards pi, it will have a bend. Then it will.
Mm-hmm.
So the thing is, you need to take some x values and y values and you need to make it out. And always keep it in mind, the period will be from 0 to 2 pi. Okay. Mm-hmm. Yes, from here to here. This is called as one period. Okay. Okay, Josh, got it?
Yep.
Yes. Okay. Now let's go to the next. Okay. So, similar way you will do for the cosine. Sine and cosine will be more of the same. Okay. So, the domain and range are real numbers and the intervals. And that means the range will be from negative 1 to 1. Okay. And y equal to cosine of x is our function. Okay. And the period is 2 pi. Okay, fine, George. Same way, the values alone differs according to the x values you are taking. Okay, now see this. Now, when you sketch the graph of basic sine and cosine functions, you need to know certain points there. Okay, we are going to see about what are the intercepts, maximum and minimum points. Okay, George, see this. The first one, the intercept is 0, 0. Okay, got it?
Yep.
Then the maximum point will be pi over 2 comma 1. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Fine. And this is the half period, you will say. First, it's the quarter period. Then this will be the half period. Okay. Which will be pi comma 0. Okay. 3/4 period will be 3 over 2 comma negative 1. And the full period, that's with one single period, is 2 pi comma 0. Okay. Yes.
Yep.
Got it, George? So the maximum point will be pi over 2, you can make a note of this. For sine function, your maximum value will be pi by 2 comma 1. Okay. On the right hand side, I'm talking about. Okay. And the minimum value will be 3 pi by 2 comma negative 1. The similar way, you can do it for the left hand side also if they're asking. Okay, George? Yes?
Yep.
Now, the next one. This is from when you're having the intervals from, according to the interval they're given. Okay. Now, this one, coming to the cosine function. When you're coming to the cosine function, the maximum value will be coming from this side, okay? Fine. Here it is. This is the full period, okay? So, maximum value will be 2 pi comma 1, okay? And the minimum value, if I'm going to take, this side it's coming, right? This is the minimum. So, pi comma negative. Got it, Josh? You understand? So this is for the cosine function and the interval is from 1 comma negative 1. Got it? Yes.
Yep.
Now, they are given an example problem. So sketch the graph of y equal to 2 times sine x. The interval changes now, negative pi to 4 pi. So in between this interval, you can take any values. Okay. Now, here they have taken, say it's negative pi. So what all the values they have taken? This is negative pi, George. Okay. That is negative 180 degree. Okay. They have taken negative 90 degree. Then 0 they have taken. Got it? You can even take any other values also. Okay. And but keep it in mind, the period will be every time it is 2 pi will be going up and down. Okay. So now see here, it's 0. Then again, it is going to 2 because actually usually it will be 1 only. Okay. It will be the wave stops here only. You can see here that small gray color line. Yes, Josh? When the interval is from negative 1 to 1, your curve will be here only. That is this place. See this? Negative 1, 0, then 1, 0, then 1, then 0, like that only. But since now it is 2 times sine x, that means what? It will get multiplied for each and everything. You understood, Josh? Yes, what I'm trying to say? Okay.
Yep.
So, After curving, they are asking us to find the intercepts, okay? So intercepts means when x equals to 0, definitely y is 0. So intercepts is 0, 0. Maximum point, where we are getting the maximum point, this point, right? So which is pi over 2, 0. Sorry, pi over 2, 2. Okay, Josh? So, the x, when you're going to take pi as your intercept, your y value is going, becoming 0, okay? Next. Your minimum value. Minimum value occurs this place, right? 3 pi over 2, -. Okay, Josh? And when your intercept, so each and everything you need to find the intercept. X equal to 0, then x equal to pi, and x equal to 2 pi. What are the intercepts? Got it? Yes? This is the first type of problem. Next. Can you try for this, Josh, for cosine function and see? And tell me, what are the intercepts? What are the maximum and minimum?
Sure, let me just draw it out.
Yes, then we will go on to the amplitude and period. Okay.
I'm just drawing it right now, sorry.
Yeah. No, take your time.
Almost done, sorry.
Yeah.
Okay, so the max values are going to be 0, 2. 2 pi and 2, and 4 pi and 2.
Yes. Oh, okay, good.
The minimum values are going to be pi negative 2 and 3 pi negative 2.
Okay.
The intercept values are going to be pi over 2, 0, 3 pi over 2, 0, 5 pi over 2, 0, 7 pi over 2, 0, and 9 pi over 2, 0.
Yes. Okay. Yes, right. Yes, George. Okay. These are the things we need to do. Okay, now let's come to the main part of amplitude and period. Okay, so when we are having the functions, sometimes we will be getting constants also along with that. Okay, not only sine x or cosine of x, along with that some constants also comes. Okay, so for example, like this, you will be getting y equals to d plus a times sine of bx minus c, and y equal to d plus a times cosine of bx minus c. Okay, so here, the constant factor a in y equal to a sine x and y equal to cosine of x, a cosine of x, acts as a scaling factor. That is, how your sine function or cosine function is going to have your vertical stretch or vertical string according to the basic curve there. Okay, George? So, when your absolute value of your a is greater than 1, okay? Like, for example, if you are going to have 2 sine x, as you had it in the previous problem, the basic curve will be stretched, okay? And if it is going to lie between 0 and 1, the curve will be shrunk, okay? So, this depends upon the value of a. So how the value of a is lying between negative a and a instead of negative 1 and 1. Okay, so the absolute value of your a, you call it to be the amplitude of the function. So the a value is very important, that will change the shape of the sine function. Okay, like little bit shrunk, or it is little bit shrink into vertical stretch or vertical shrink, whatever it is going to have. Okay, so that a value is very important. That absolute value, if you take for that a, that's called as an amplitude of the function. Okay, so the range of the function for a greater than 0 is a negative a to a. Okay, so what is the definition of an amplitude of sine and cosine curve? So when you are going to have y equal to a sine x or a cosine of x, okay, if it is going to represent the half distance between the maximum and minimum values, okay, see for example, half distance is this one, okay, I would have shown you here, yes, this is the half period, okay. Okay, George? Yes?
Yep.
So, half distance means the amplitude of will be absolute value of A. Okay? Fine, George? Mm-hmm. So, in the same coordinate plane, you need to sketch this one. For example, we will try this one. See, y equal to 1 over 2 cosine of x. So, amplitude will be, here A value is what? 1 upon 2. Okay? So, the maximum value is 1 upon 2 and the minimum value will be negative 1 upon 2. Okay, now we are going to divide one cycle, that is 0 to 2 pi. Okay, and we are going to divide it into four equal parts. 0, pi over 2, pi, 3 pi over 2 and 2 pi. Okay, and we can make it out. So amplitude is just absolute value of 1 over 2. Okay, Josh, you understand? Mm-hmm. Next one, 3 cosine of x. In this case, what will happen? The amplitude will be 3 here because absolute value of 3 is nothing but 3. Okay? Fine? Mm-hmm. And you are going to split the interval again into 4 equal parts from 0, pi upon 2, pi, 3, pi upon 2, and 2 pi. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
So, let's try for the next one. Period. Okay? So, when I'm talking about the period of a given graph, okay? So, in the graph, suppose, for example, y equal to negative f of x. It becomes a reflection in the x-axis for the given graph of y equal to f of x. Okay, fine? Mm-hmm. So, when I'm going to consider the effect of positive real number b on the graph, y equal to a sine bx. You are going to consider like this, okay? For example, they are considering y equal to a sine x, y equal to a sine bx. They are going to compare these two graphs. Okay. Now, mm-hmm. y equal to a sine x is completing one cycle from 0 to 2 pi. Okay. So, a sine bx will be completing, when it will complete the one full cycle, 0 to 2 pi over b. Okay, George? So, the period formula will be, let b be a positive real number, the period of y equal to a sine bx and y equal to a cos bx will be 2 pi over b. This is the formula we need to get. Use it to calculate the period formula. Okay? Yes, George? Mm-hmm. For example, they have taken a value. Okay? And this b value, like a, what will happen? Like a gives you the vertical shrink and vertical stretch. This b value in the given function will tell you how the graph is going to have a horizontal stretch and horizontal shrink. Okay? So, if b is greater than 1, the period will be less than 2 pi, okay? And it will have a horizontal shrink, okay? And when it is going to lie between 0 and 1, it will have a horizontal stretch. Okay, George? Yes?
Mm-hmm.
And suppose when b is going to be negative, you need to rewrite the function and then graph it out. Okay, George? So, sine of negative x is nothing but negative sine x. Because why we are writing this? Sine, sometimes you won't get, when you type it in your calculator also, sine of negative 180 degree, that and all value will not come, right? You have to take the negative sign, you calculate it, put the negative sign along with the number, whatever you're getting. Okay? Yes?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
We are going to just have a horizontal stretching here. So, y equal to sine x upon 2. So, here, b value is nothing but 1 upon 2. Okay? So, the period formula is 2 pi upon b. So, that means it is 2 pi upon 1 upon 2. Okay? So, that would be 4 pi. Okay? Fine, George? Now, it's the same type. You are going to divide the interval into 4 intervals. You will find the intercepts, maximum, minimum values. Okay. Yes, George?
Yep.
Okay. Yes. Can you try this and see y equal to cosine of x over 3?
Sure. So it's just asking to find the period, right?
Yes.
So the period out would just basically be 6 pi.
Okay. Right. Okay. Now coming to the concept of translation of sine and cosine curves. Please let me know if any topics or something is removed from the textbook. Okay, we are going out of that. Okay.
No, so this is following like the general path of it going. Now we're just learning about C, right?
Yeah. Yes. So this is like all these things are there in your textbook, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Okay. Good. Fine. Coming to your translation of the sine and cosine curves. Okay. So we have taken a general function of y equal to a sine of bx minus c and y equal to a cosine of bx minus c. Okay. So here there is an horizontal translation. Okay. That means, see, for example, I'm going to compare a sine bx and a sine bx minus c. Okay. Now, this curve will complete one cycle from bx minus c equals to 0. Yeah, that means what? Bx minus c is 2 pi. Okay. To 2 pi. That is 0 to 2 pi is one period. Right. Okay. One cycle means. So, now I'm going to solve this. So x is going to lie between left end point will be c over b and right end point will be this. Okay, fine, George. So The phase shift we are going to find it out. Okay, so when I'm going to have a period of y equal to this is the period for this is 2 pi over b and the graph of y equal to a sine bx will be shifted to an amount of c upon b. The C upon B, you call it to be the phase shift. The graph is little bit moved to one place. So answer. Okay? Yes, John? That is called as a phase shift. Got it? Now, when you are going to have a graph of sine and cosine function, the amplitude formula is absolute value of A. Period is 2 pi over B. The left and the right end points of one cycle interval can be determined by the following equation. Okay, Josh? Yes, got it. Yes, I think the other things are of the same type. Okay. Any other thing? This is for the horizontal translation. Okay. They have taken a problem. Amplitude is nothing but 3 and 2 pi over b. So that would be 2 pi over 2 pi, which is 1. Okay.
And one more thing too. Inside the question where you said like x minus c equal to, you said it's 0, right? X minus c equals 0.
Wait, George, 1 minute. This one you're saying where?
Yeah, or yeah, because isn't that what you do? Because if you go down, he sets the person who did the equation later sets the equation inside the parentheses equal to 0.
That means what he's doing is see, always the period is he wants to find the interval. The interval is not given here. Okay. To find the interval, what he is doing is he is taking the inside value, that is this bx minus c. He is setting it up first. He is setting, because we know one thing, that the whole cycle is from 0 to 2 pi. So first he is setting it to 0 and finding the value of x from that. Then
he's setting it to 2 pi.
And find the value of x. So that will give you one full cycle. That is one whole interval what you need to get. Okay.
So then with the cycle. So then if you get 7 pi over 3 and then pi over 3, what does that mean then?
That means that your interval is for this given function will be pi over 3 to 7 pi over 3. Okay?
Okay.
Mm-hmm. So you have the intercepts first, you need to take pi over 3 and in between that next value, you can take any whatever you want. Okay? But the end value should be pi 7 pi over 3. Okay? That means the closed interval will be this one. Okay? Fine? So this is the way you need to find the interval if it is not given. If it is given, then no problem. But if it is not given, you need to equate it to 0 and find the value. And one more, you will equate it to 2 pi because we already know that one cycle is 2 pi. Okay?
Okay.
Okay. Now the next one. The vertical translation, the same type, it will happen. Okay? So the key points will be the interval is from 0 to pi. Okay? So same way you need to make it out. Okay? Yes, Josh? Let's try some problems because you don't have your word problems. I'm just going into the problems directly. Okay. First, we will find the period and amplitude for this number 5.
Sorry. So for the amplitude of that would basically just be 2. And the period of that would just basically will be 2 pi over 5.
Yes. Okay. Number 6.
Number six, that'll basically be for the amplitude 3, and for the period, it'll just be pi.
Yes. Let's try a different one. What about number 11?
No, quick second, sorry. For number 11, the amplitude of that one would just basically be 5 over 3, despite the negative sign, and the period of that would just basically be 2 pi over 1 times 12 over pi, which would just basically be just 24.
Yes, George. Okay, so the next one, okay. Now, you need to describe the relationship between the graph of f and g. Consider amplitude, period, and shift here, okay? So let's start with number 13.
Okay, so for 13, consider amplitude, period, and shift. So the amplitude of 13 for f of x is going to be 1, and same thing for g of x. The period of, frequency of f of x is going to be 1, but the frequency of g of x is going to be 5. The period of f of x is going to be 2 pi, while the period of g of x is going to be 2 pi over 5. And there's going to be no phase or vertical shifts for either of them.
Yes. Okay. So the next one, one second. What about number 20?
For number 20, the amplitudes of both f of x and g of x are going to be 1. The frequencies of both f of x and g of x are going to be 4, which means that the periods of both f of x and g of x are going to be pi over 2.
Yes.
There's no phase or vertical shift for f of x, but although there's no phase shift for g of x, there is a vertical shift of 2 units down.
Yes, very good, George. Okay, so now from the graph, you need to identify number 24. Can you try?
Sure. So 24 is obviously going to be a sine graph because it starts at the midline point when considering the y-axis.
Okay.
The amplitude seems to be only 1, so it's going to have one term from it. So it's going to be sine of x, and it completes one full cycle at, let me see, it doesn't really seem to complete the full thing, but it sure seems to, give me one quick second. I'm guessing it's going to take 4 pi, so I'm guessing that's going to be 1 half x. Is that correct?
Yes, Josh, correct. Yes. Okay.
Huh. Okay. I couldn't tell exactly. I just have to gauge it.
No. Correct.
Okay.
Same coordinate plane. Okay, this is fine. The graphing part is fine. Just try with number 51 and see.
Sure. So for the just amplitude, that's going to be two-thirds.
Just one second.